Actually, in the South Korea, like the new broadcasting, like people around the world are afraid, and like the same as Cambodian people who live in Cambodia, they also are afraid of their relative who come to work or study here in South Korea. But the situation here is seem like stable. People like go to work and study normally, so people like got frightened, but not so much of the people living outside the South Korea, because like the situation here is quite simple, quite normal.
Are you planning to stay or leave South Korea? Are you worried about your own security?
It's the important question. My family also asked me like this.
Yeah, I'm sure your parents are
Oh,
worried,
sure.
very worried.
Well, I believe that the war will not happen, so I think that I should not leave because the situation here is like not really, not really bad like the people around the world think, because we can see the normal situation here, so the frightening is like lower than the people outside.
And that's what I've been reading in the newspapers here too, is this the same thing you're saying, which is that people in South Korea, this is their, as you say, they're more stable. This is more sort of almost normal, although obviously things are not normal right now. But people in other countries are seem, more concerned.
And what city are you living in right now in Korea?
Yes, excuse me.
Are you in Seoul or somewhere else?
And in Daegu, in the south part of Seoul, like travel by train, like 2 hours.
Wow. And what are you doing in Korea?
And come here to study in Korea
What do you?
for the master degree.
Wow.
In what subject?
Actually, I have like 2 years of master degree, but because I'm a Korean government scholarship student, so I need to study the Korean language for 1 year before going to university. So now I'm studying Korean language, and hopefully after passing the language, I will go to master degree in political economy.
I actually took a class recently in a international political economy class. It was
Oh, really?
really interesting.
Interesting.
How do you define political economy? Why don't you explain to us what political economy or international political economy means?
Actually, in terms of politics and economy, it's like interrelated. So a very important part in developing one country. So these two parts is the most important one. So if the economy is better, so the economy also good. But if the politics is not stable in one country, the economy will be bad.
That makes sense.
So are you approaching it more as a political scientist or as an economist?
Actually, I focus like in the major is public policy. But the minor is in political economy. So I'm focused more not really in economy, but to the policy.
And what are your plans when you finish your
Master's, yeah.
master's?
We'll go back to Cambodia to work there for Cambodia, developing my country, not here in Korea. They develop enough here. So in Cambodia, the human resource in this field is still limited, so it's important to go back.
More immediately, what are your plans for the Cambodian New Year? Even though you're in South Korea, are you going to be celebrating?
Actually, I'm invited as the student representative of my university to join with the ambassador in Seoul. But since it's quite far away from here, and
you should go.
Yeah, the transportation is very expensive. The problem for me is just a student.
but you should ask the embassy to send a car for you to
drive a limousine. They should send a limousine to you and say it's Cambodian New Year.
I mean, do you have the chance to appear with the ambassador? That might make you great connections.
That's true. It might be worth, you know, paying for the transportation.
To network. You know the expression to network and to make connections, meet people. You might meet someone who will help you, you know, in your career down the road. So
Yeah. Actually, I went there like last week to Seoul for joining the rewarding ceremony of the ASEAN Korean Center. So like just 1 week, if I go there again, so it's like, it's too much cold, you know?
Yes.
But I know that it's very important. I really want to join. But
yeah. So what are you going to do instead if you're going to not go there?
Maybe in New Year, just call to my family and ask them and join the Happy New Year, like on phone or on Skype.
I have
a chance to go there.
New Year's celebration by Skype.
Yeah, sure. It's the way of the high tech nowadays.
Yes.
Well, it was great talking to you. Do you have any message for people back in Cambodia who might see this video on YouTube? Do you have anything you'd like to say to them?
Yeah. Just want to say Happy New Year to all Cambodian people and wish them have a good day, a good luck in the new year, and like try to work more and study more for developing our country. Yeah, we believe that Cambodia is step forward right now, even if it'll be a bit slow, but hopefully we will grow up in the future.